Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You are watching For Take. I am using my Nothing Phone 1 with the old Nothing OS version 1.1.3. We have created the changelog review along with the battery performance testing of that update. You can watch that video from the iCard. Yesterday, Nothing has released 132 MB size OTA update Nothing OS 1.1.4, which has used changelog like the old dope update. So today in this video, we will see the full changelog review of Nothing OS 1.1.4. CPU throttling test of new update and the benchmark testing with the Geekbench. Battery life results will be posted with another video or with the community post. So I started the download of new update. Now without further ado, let's get started. On a new adventure. Download has completed. Let's tap restart to flash the new update. This flashing of new update taken 15 to 20 minutes. It's gone through the system update installation, then phone got restarted, and then again took 10 minutes to updating the system. Finally phone booted. Now let's jump to the about phone to see the new changelog. Here we will see we are upgraded to the new Nothing OS 1.1.4. Build number is spacebar 1.1, 13 September 2022. If you check the Android version, it's the same Android 12 with the old Matrelu easter egg. As per the Kalpay tweet, we will get the Android 13 update in upcoming year 2023. Android security patch is of September 2022, except that other things are old one. Now let's start the review of new changelog. As per the changelog, they added the new buttons layout in the system gestures. If you go to the system gestures, they enable the three buttons navigation gesture. And tap on the gear icon, we get the buttons layout tab. By using that, we can change the navigation buttons layout. If you are using the Bluetooth earphones which supports the high definition audio codecs, then the new update has added new LSDC codec support. But they are only available if your device supports these codecs. Like here, I am using my Oppo Echo M31 earphones which supports only SBC, ACC and LDAC codecs. So other codecs options are grayed off along with the LSDC. New update has the inbuilt Nothing Ear 1 application, so as soon as you connect the Nothing Ear 1 buds, apps detects and opens automatically. But here I am using the Oppo earphone, so I can't able to access the application. Another major changes has been added for the camera application. Now Nothing has added the Nothing logo and the date watermark option in a setting, and it will look like this after taking the pictures. In the ultra wide pictures, they again done the improvement like the ultra wide camera color calibration improvement and increased color consistency between main and ultra wide sensors. They added the new motion detection algorithm for improved stability when shooting the moving objects. So here I didn't have moving objects to check this. So what I did, I played one video of moving objects on another device and then shooted the video using Nothing Phone 1. After shooting this video, you can't even understand this clip is shooted with the mobile. It feels like we are playing another streaming media on our Nothing Phone 1. So definitely stability of moving objects has definitely improved in the camera application. Another improvement that I have made for the increasing shooting speed for the ultra wide and the HDR mode. But I found that HDR will not work along with the ultra wide while shooting the videos. It will get automatically disabled, so it's not possible to shoot the ultrawide videos in the HDR mode. You can either use one of them while shooting the videos. Now let's check out the improvements and the fixes done in the new OTA. First, they tried to improve the battery consumption while using the AOD, and in other cases, I personally facing the heavy battery drain on Nothing OS 1.1.3. So I will definitely check how is the battery life of this new update in the another video. Another improvement has been done for the thermal performance. To check this, I had done the CPU throttle test by enabling the CPU temperature option on the 20 threads for the 5 minutes. While test, CPU temperature risen from the 48 degrees Celsius to 50 degrees Celsius. When I stopped the test after 5 minutes, I got the score of 94% CPU throttling, which is same as the old build. CPU temperature got cooled down immediately after the test. Nothing Phone 1 already had the better capability to maintain the thermal performance, and with this new update, it is one more additional step up for the more improvement. They added the new user interface for the system update, but I didn't see any of these user interface changes here. They improved the face unlock algorithm, so the face unlock works faster with the great accuracy. And I felt that in the actual users also, face unlock works faster and accurately as compared to the previous builds. They fix some network issues for the carriers and fix some contacts shown as unknown while incoming calls. Another bug for the HDFC app fingerprint not working is also fixed here. As you can see, I can log into the account using fingerprint authentication. Instead of this, some general bug fixing has been done. Finally, the question arises, how is the performance of the new update? Actually, nothing OS is already fluid and fast, but on the old update, I felt some sudden lag while using any task. This time, I didn't feel such issues, so I did the comparison of old Geekbench results with the new update. For CPU performance on the single core, I got the score of 703 and 2690 for the multi-core. If you check the last time result, it was 693 and 2676 respectively. So this time results are slightly improved, but the GPU performance on the OpenGL drivers I got 2225, while on the Vulkan graphics API results I got 2591. Both of these results are closer to the old update results. So in the numbers and the real life performance, both of these updates are same. What is major bug in this update? Last time some users faced a charging issue, phone takes nearly 3 to 4 hours to charge the phone fully. And that issue is still persist here, phone took 13% of charging per hour. Though I used a OnePlus 65 watt fast charger for charging, this is the major issue, so it must be fixed. So this is all about the new nothingOS 1.1.4, soon I will upload the another video for the battery results. Till then, if you think I help you, then please do like and share this video, subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for the notification of upcoming content. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.